Welcome to Dear Art channel. In this video, I talk about passive cooling techniques. I divide this topic into three questions. First, what is passive cooling? Second, what's the purpose of passive cooling? Third, some techniques of passive cooling. First, what is passive cooling? Passive cooling systems are least expensive means of cooling a home, which maximizes the efficiency of the building and without any use of mechanical devices. It rely on natural heat sink to remove the heat from the building. They derive cooling directly from evaporation, convection, and radiation, without using any intermediate electrical devices. All passive cooling strategies rely on daily changes in temperature and relative humidity. The applicability of each system depends on the climatic conditions because there are different types of zones. Next, what's the purpose of passive cooling? The purpose of passive cooling provides indoor comfort, low maintenance, zero low energy consumption, low running cost, promotes healthy environment, save the earth. Passive cooling building design attempts to integrate principle of physics into the building exterior envelope to slow heat transfer into a building, remove unwanted heat from a building. Third question is, some techniques of passive cooling. Passive cooling techniques are natural ventilation, shading, wind towers, courtyard effect, earth air tunnels, evaporative cooling, passive down draft cooling, roof sprays, and roof pond. The first is a natural ventilation. In order to have a good natural ventilation, opening must be placed at opposite pressure zones. Also, designers often choose to enhance natural ventilation using tall spaces called stacks in buildings. Shown in figure, natural ventilation house work with openings near the top of stacks. Warm air can escape whereas cooler air enters the building from the openings near the ground. The windows play a dominant role in inducing indoor ventilation due to wind forces. Shading. The most effective method of cooling a building is to shade windows, walls, and roof of building from the direct solar radiation. Extend the overhang beyond the sides of the window to prevent solar gain from the side. Use settled or lowered shade to allow more daylight to enter while shading windows from direct sunlight. Reduce solar heat gain by recessing windows into the wall. Wind towers. In a wind tower, the hot air enters the tower through the openings in the tower, gets cooled, and thus becomes heavier and sinks down. The inlet and outlet of rooms induce cool air movement. Shown in figure, how it's worked. In the presence of wind, air is cooled more effectively and flows faster down the tower and into the living area. Courtyard effect. Cool air from the ground level flows through the lowered openings of rooms surrounding a courtyard, thus producing airflow. At night, the warm roof surfaces get cooled by convection and radiation. the effect of courtyard shown in figure. If the roof surfaces are sloped toward the internal courtyard, the cold air sinks into the court and enters the living space through low-level openings. Get warmed up and leaves the room through higher level openings. Earth air tunnels at a depth of about 4 meters below ground. The temperature inside the earth remains nearly constant round the year and is nearly equal to the annual average temperature of the place. A tunnel in the form of a pipe or otherwise embedded at a depth of about 4 meters below the ground will acquire the same temperature as the surrounding earth at its surface. Therefore, the ambient air ventilated through this tunnel will get cooled in summer and warm in winter. This air can be used for cooling in summer and heating in winter. Figure shows the function of earth air tunnel. Next is evaporative cooling. In evaporative cooling, the sensible heat of air is used to evaporate water, thereby cooling the air, which in turn cools the living space, the building. It is effective in hot and dry climate, where the atmospheric humidity is low. Shown in figure how it's for evaporative cooling. The presence of a water body such as pond, lake and sea near the building or a fountain in a courtyard can provide a cooling effect. The most commonly used system in a desert cooler, which comprises water, evaporative pads, a fan and a pump. Passive down draught cooling. In this system, wind catchers guide outside air over water filled pots, inducing evaporation and causing a significant drop in temperature before the air enters the interior. Shown in figure how air enters. Such wind catcher become primary element of the architecture form and also its function. Roof pond and sprays. Roof pond is a passive cooling technique based upon the increased heat capacity of cheap and widely available water. In general, the pond is covered during day to prevent heating and open at night to be cooled. Shown in figure how it's work and function of roof pond. This figure shows the roof sprays. Bye. Dear Raj, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Thank you so much.